This is my amazing super duper review of the Roltenacacos Resort in Varadero, Cuba. This resort is run by Rolten, which is a Canadian company. This is a 5-star experience. This is the main pool. It's kept in an extremely clean condition. These are the grounds. They are very well kept. This was a groundskeeper who was scaling this palm tree to get to the coconuts. He made it look quite easy. I could have done it too, but I didn't feel like it. There's a lot of modern art that's scattered throughout the grounds. Some of it is so modern it's hard to figure out what it is. After much thought, I named this one the Hammer. This is the pathway to the beach. Like most resorts in the Caribbean, the natural vegetation and mangrove forest is preserved. This helps prevent soil and sand erosion. Otherwise, whenever there's a hurricane, all this white sand would wind up on the resort buildings. As far as the white sand turquoise water experience, this resort delivers. Unlike Cancun, which at this time of the year usually has a lot of sargassum seaweed, there was no sargassum seaweed here whatsoever. I took this shot from the roof of the Varadero Golf and Country Club. On the resort, there are tennis courts. These people were playing in 32 degrees Celsius heat. I'm not sure how they didn't pass out. The rooms are grouped into individual houses, which are all color-coded. This is my room at the resort. It was very well maintained. And it was very clean. As soon as you enter the room, there's a small seating area. Beside that is your bed with a ceiling fan, and the room had excellent air conditioning. Kept it ice cool the whole time. There's a small desk beside your bed with a telephone. This is the bathroom. It's got a vanity with well stocked with shampoo, conditioner, and soap. This is the tub, and shower. This is the mandatory shot of the toilet. There's an in-suite safe for your valuables. These are the plugs in the rooms. They're a 220-volt recessed European plugs. When I first saw this coming from Canada, I was like, what the? I then did extensive research, got my electrical engineering degree, and after that, I come to the conclusions that what you need is first, you need an electrical adapter that fits into the recessed hole. This will convert the European plug to the North American two-prong standard. You then need to have a electrical voltage converter, which will change the voltage from 220 volts to 110 volts. There's also a flat-screen TV in the room. It gets a lot of good channels, including CNN and CTV News from Canada. This is your balcony. Then, to my horror, I noticed this bug crawling in my room on one of the lamps. It sent a shiver down my spine and my whole body started to shake. I called the front desk and said, "There's a bugs in my room. What's going on?" They said, "Don't worry, senor. We'll send someone up right away to check it out." The guy then looked around and said, "No, senor, that's not a bug. Those are the screws on the lamp." What can I say? You know, like the bumper sticker says, shit happens. There's a really nice light show that goes on at the water features of the resort every single night. This is the main gymnasium on the resort. Well equipped with good cardio equipment. There's also a range of weightlifting equipment also. Here I made this video of this gentleman I saw. He's obviously a very powerful body lifter. I have no idea who he is, but look at that form and look at those heavy weights he's lifting. And at the same time, he's a very friendly guy. I didn't go to the spa, so all I can say that there is a big golden head at the entrance. The friendly buffet staff. One day I was just walking in the resort and then the showgirl started bothering me and said that they wanted to take a selfie with me. Why do these showgirls always bother me to take selfies with them? You know, I'm trying to mind my own business, but they always want selfies with me. What is the problem? Someone in the comments, please explain to me, what is their problem? As you can see in this video, I am not instructing them in any way whatsoever. Everything that they're doing at this point is spontaneous and of their own free will and without any coaching. Orchi! Blowing kisses. They're blowing kisses now. What is their problem? There's also nightly shows 7 days a week. Each one has different themes. These are all the performers that were in the shows. There were some guys in there too. But unfortunately, I don't know where the pictures went. You know, what can I say? Sometimes these things happen. Of all the nightly shows, I thought that the water show was the best. I'll just leave this clip here for you to enjoy. On the beach, there is a aquatic center for the resort. Here, you can rent out a catamaran for a fishing trip for 3 hours for $100 US. You can also pay $20 to go snorkeling. And what's available are these hobby cats and also the smaller paddle boats. I decided to take the hobby cat out for a fishing combination snorkeling trip. As you can see in this, I'm now getting ready for the signature shot of my trip. There he is. He's happy. He's living the dream in Varadero, Cuba, fishing for barracuda. The hobby cats are using the wind power, and with that we are trolling, and all environmentally friendly with no engine and no gas fumes whatsoever. Okay, I'm getting tired now. That's enough of the signature shot business. That's it. So that's Joel there. He took me out and we caught on one trip, we caught two barracuda. These barracuda are great fighting fish. They jump out of the water multiple times, at least two, three times as you're reeling them in, and they really run. So good, I went back again for a second fishing trip and I caught this monster barracuda. It was almost about the same size as me. And I also did the snorkeling when I went out with Joel. And as you can see, I'm all ready to go over the edge, and there it is. The snorkeling was actually quite good, and the water was crystal clear. As you can see, there's a lot of fish as soon as you go in. On the bottom, there's a huge schools of fish. I was quite surprised. I didn't expect to see that many. Compared to other places in the Caribbean, the amount of fish in these waters, I was quite impressed. And this was right off in front of the resort. I'll just leave this here for you to enjoy. This is me coming back to the resort with the hobby cat. As you can see, they like pumping their music really loud. This is not overlay music, it's actually coming from that hut on the beach. Hey, come on! Turn the music down! Turn it down! For $60 Canadian, you can rent a classic car. For 3 hours. This is a 1955 Pontiac convertible. This video has been taken by the driver. He does a complete 360 of his vehicle. For some reason, he's really proud of this Apululu sign. I don't even know what it was, but he seemed to like it. Cuba is full of these classic cars from the 1950s. It's illegal to import a drone into Cuba. In this shot, I'm demonstrating my new invention called the Cuban drone. It's my GoPro mounted on a very long stick. You just hold it up as high as you can, stand on your tippy toes on the back seat, and there you have it, the Cuban drone. Enjoy the view. This is another one of my inventions. I'm too cheap to get a 360-degree camera, so this is my own manual 360 camera. You just hold your GoPro on a long stick and turn it in a complete circle. Same 360 effect. At this point though, the G-forces on my body have started to become extreme and I'm holding onto my GoPro with dear life. For an extra charge, you can have dinner on the beach at sunset. All in all, I thought that this resort delivered on its white sand turquoise water experience. The end. Like, comment, and subscribe me. Do it! Do it! Please! Do it!